Hey guys, so I'm back with another install, but this time I'm gonna show you guys my technique on how I cut my lace as well as how I make the lace front fit to a unique forehead. Okay guys, so as you can tell, not everyone's forehead is gonna be the same, and sometimes the way they make the lace, it just doesn't fit the client's shape of her head. So what I have to do is I have to modify it to fit. And today we're gonna be going into details on how I achieve that. So the first thing you want to do is have a flat foundation, guys. So her hair is a little fine, so that's why you see me here adding in a little bit of extension to it so that I can have a strong base for when I sew the wig down. So what I always do, guys, and this is my new technique, is I make that first braid go around the back of her neck. I hate when I see the braids are going straight back and it lifts at the back, and it's just horrible because you can't get the wig to fit properly. So today I'm using Myfirstwig, which is a great wig if you're a beginner and it's literally your first wig. So these wigs are made to like last. It comes with a wig stand, hair wax, edge band, crocodile clips, wig caps, and a wig band, as well as the wig, of course. So with this wig, it's gonna come pre-bleached with the knots. It's gonna come pre-plucked. So typically, like if you are a first-time wig wearer, this is the type of wig you want to wear. It comes with a 13x4 lace, so you can get a deep middle part, 12 inch on this wig, and it's a color 1B. So I always try to go in and, you know, moisturize my client's head, especially if they're gonna be wearing this wig for a while. So that's what I'm doing there. And then I'm going to put the freeze and spray on their edge to lay their little baby hairs, like slick it back so that it's out the way of the wig, guys. You always want to like get those things out the way, and I use the got to be freeze spray to do that. So what I'm doing here is I'm using a little alcohol to clean up her forehead, because you know I don't like a messy forehead while I'm doing this. But let me jump into this part, guys. So right here, I see a lot of people do that, and we don't wanna see that. So like, I really have to commit to the wig cap. I cannot just slap the wig cap on my client's head and keep it moving. Like, I have to commit to getting the wig cap fully sewn on. And this is where we're gonna do right here, which I have to pull it down under her hairline, cut the ears out, get those nice and tucked in. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the got to be glue again and I'm gonna spray it over. But before you do that, you want to put the makeup on. You want one that matches, and I always like to use the Ruby Kisses. I think this is a color 12, and I use the lightest one in that color, and I match it to the client's skin before I even try to put it on the wig cap, to just so I know it's a close proximity to her natural skin complexion. Then you wanna go along her hairline from what you can see through the cap, and you wanna go ahead and spray the Gots to Be glue on that as close to her hairline as possible. And then when that dries, you're gonna go ahead and cut it out along her hairline. Please try to not show as much baby hair as possible. Like when you're cutting, just make sure you're not like cutting too far back to where her little baby hairs are showing, because you know when we put the glue down, it's gonna stick to her hair, and we are not in the business of making your clients lose hair. We're in the business of protection. So even though it is a wig, we still want to protect your client hair as much as possible. So here I am, I'm just going in and I'm trying to fit the wig on her head properly. And as you can see, the wig shape is not the same shape as her head, and I'm just not gonna give her a new forehead. Like, why does your client have to walk out with a brand new forehead? No, they want to look the same. They want to come get the wig and they want to walk away looking how they sat in your chair, but with a new hairdo, you know. So what I'm doing is I'm basically parting out the sections that along from the cap, what I can see through the wig, I'm parting that out. And this part right here, as much work as they put into this wig of, you know, plucking it, and they did a great job, but we needed to match her forehead. So what I did was I parted through where her forehead is, and now I'm going to pluck that part because I kind of part further back to where they hadn't plucked yet. So that's why you see me plucking it some more so that it still gives it a natural look, you guys. So all of that hair right there is going to get cut off because it just doesn't go with her natural hairline. And there I am. I'm just plucking, plucking, plucking. The more you pluck, you know, the more natural the hairline's going to look. But you got to be careful not to make bald spots within the wig. It's so easy to get carried away when you're plucking because you're like, is it enough? Is it not enough? So go ahead and just be careful when you're doing that. So I'm just getting those hair out the way as I'm getting ready to cut. And the way you want to cut, guys, is in a zigzag line. And you're going to be able to see when I do that. But for now, I'm just getting those little hairs out the way. And you want to cut the tab that goes behind her ear. You see that right there? That is over her ear. I don't want that. So you're going to cut that lace part off around her ear. Be careful when you do this. Please do not just go cutting blindly. You need to see what you're doing. Like, I just pull that down so that I can see what I'm doing, and then I'm going to cut that off. So now when I go upwards along her hairline, I'm going to do it in a zigzag kind of just not straight. You don't want it to be straight, so you want a little bit of texture to your line. So as you see, I'm going back and forth as I'm going up so that it's not like a straight line. No one has a straight forehead. So when you do this, you kind of want to make some riggedy, you know, just some texture as you're going through the forehead. To do that. So that's what I'm doing there, guys. So this is gonna give it a natural look when once you have it a complete look, you're gonna get a really natural look because, you know, it's not gonna go straight across their head like they used to cut back in the day. You know, things have advanced since then. So we're doing a lot more now than we used to do when we first started doing lace fronts. And when I'm cutting, guys, I am cutting a little bit, like a quarter inch more than her hairline where I had that cap. So you don't want it to be exactly where the cap ends. You want it to be a little bit over. And as you're going to be able to see when I do put the glue on, because we're fully committing to this wig, she's going to be wearing it for some time. But if, you know, if it is your first wig and you just wanted to throw it on and go, you can absolutely, you don't need to use the glue. You could just use the got to be spray and, you know, you can spray that and go. You don't need to use the glue like I'm going to do. But since she's going to be wearing this wig for at least 2 weeks, we want to make sure that it is going to stay on her head. So we're going to use the glue. And I'm just going in and I'm just, you know, plucking some more to make it look a little bit natural. And what I like to do, guys, is when I see the black dots, I know this is pre-bleach, but sometimes they don't get every single strand. I like to kind of pluck on the black dots just to get rid of them because obviously that's the dead giveaway right there. And in order to have a more natural look, I like to get rid of those. So when I'm doing my glue down, I do about 3 to 4 layers, guys. And this is if your client is going to be wearing this wig for a long time. You want it to stay on their head. We're no longer just doing one layer. We got to do layers. So once this layer dries, I'll know when it dries because it turns clear just like that. And I've already put on 3 other layers. I didn't show y'all, but I did it. So now I'm putting the wig on and I'm just making sure it's on correctly and it's gonna match up with how I cut it to the hairline. So I'm getting all the little frizzies, all the hair out the way so that I can get a nice lay. So right now you can see it, obviously we can all see it, but you know, in a few minutes, you're not gonna be able to see nothing. So just keep watching, y'all. Before y'all start judging and talking and doing all that, just keep watching to see how I'm able to just make all that stuff go away and for it to have a seamless, melted look. So what I'm doing here is spraying down the Got To Be Glue. It's gonna help it stick a little bit more to her forehead, even though the glue is there, the Got To Be spray just kind of, since the glue is not going to get every single part of the lace, it's basically going to stick the ends that it didn't get to her forehead. All right, guys, so what you're gonna need is the elastic band. This is the magic worker right here. This elastic band is going to basically melt the lace into her head. You're tying it down, not too tight to where they can't think, but you wanna tie it tight enough to where it's going to melt the lace in her head. And I normally keep this on. I normally, after I do this, I'll go ahead and I style the wig and, you know, do whatever I need to do. If it was a straight wig, I'll flat iron it, style it, whatever. But for here, it's a curly wig. So what I'm going to do is spray some water on it. And I'm using the Camille Rose Custard to define those curls. I love the way it just made those curls look so beautiful. It's a great product. So that's what I'm using to define those curls. Melted almost. So now you gotta go ahead and get the baby hairs going. So I pull out a little bit at a time along her hairline, and then I'll decide if do I want to put some back, or you know how much I want to put back, or I might pluck some out. But you just want, you don't want too much baby hair, but you know, just pull it out. Especially for curly hair, I do feel like you kind of need some baby hair, because it just, I feel like girls that do have natural curly hair be having baby hair. So, you know, give them some baby hair so that it looks more natural. Yeah, and you know, this part where everybody gets scared and they start flinching and stuff, like everybody's scared of the flat iron, girl, just take it. And I'm not going to burn you. Just take it, girl. Look at her face. She's scared. All right, so for the baby hair, y'all, little gem here is you want to do some small cuts. You don't want the long, oh my God, I hate them long ones. Please cut them small. It looks way more natural when those baby hairs are shorter and you just go ahead and swoop them. If you are not a professional, please do not use mousse to lay your baby hair. I am using it because you have to be quick with it, guys. First of all, as soon as you put the mousse on, the lace will start to lift. So if you're not a professional, do not use mousse. The lace starts to lift, but you know, that's when you go ahead and put the wrap on and it goes straight back down. But you have to be quick because, yeah, your lace will start to lift once the mousse hits it. And bam, that's the finished look, guys. I hope you like it. It definitely looks melted. She can wear it without that part because the part did look a little orange. But now she looks so natural. You can barely tell it's melted. You can't tell me nothing else. It's melted. That's her head. That's her natural hairline. Look at her hairline, guys. That's what she stepped in my chair with. The same hairline she about to walk away with is what she stepped in my chair with, okay? Not a new front hairline. Not a hairline pulled down to her eyebrows. That's what she stepped in my chair with. That's what she's leaving with. So this is how you cut your lace as well as make it customized to your client's hairline so that they look natural and they don't look like a brand new person. Thank you guys for watching.